Now let's continue with the columns. As you see here, except for here and here, where we have shear walls on two sides, we have columns on the rest of the grids. And if I go to the second page here, you can see the columns are 315 by 342. So I'm going to go to the Structure tab. I'm going to use Columns, and I want to load some wood columns by going to the Structural Columns folder here. Notice that there is a column folder over there. We are not using that. We are using Structural Columns, and it's wood. I want to use one of these columns. This one is 79 by 152. I'm going to duplicate it, name it as 315 by 342. So 315 by 342. 342 by 315. Okay. So as you see, the columns are like horizontally here, so that's why I assigned the larger number to B and 315 to D. Okay, now I want to go with add grids, right? And now I can select everything, and it's going to automatically know the intersection. So I'm going to just finish. It says it cannot see the structure here. That's good. That's probably because of the view range and the level of detail. So I'm going to change this to fine, and I'm going to type VR for the view range. This is level 1. Maybe I could look below here. Okay, there we go. Now I want to delete these columns here and here, because as you see, we have some shear walls over there and over there. Okay, the rest of the columns, I want them to go from level 1 to level 2, and I want 0 amount of offset. Okay, we have one view of the structure here. Okay, so as you see, the columns are not continuous. There is one plate in between. That's why I'm going to create columns in each level. And then I'm going to model that plate. Okay, so now all columns are selected. There are 28 of them. And it goes from L1 to L2. I want to copy them and paste them to selected level. First in level 2. Okay, it goes from L2 to L3. And I want to change the top offset to 0 for now. Okay, and all 28 of them are still selected. I want to go copy and paste them to level 3. They go from L3 to the roof. I want the offsets to be 0 for now. We can take care of the offsets later. So if I go to a 3D view, it's just like this. Okay. Now let's take care of the beams. If I go to a different view here, you see we have one plan showing typical floor framing above, okay, which is for level 2 and level 3, but for the roof, there is this other plan showing the roof. So some of the structural elements are different in the roof and in the levels below. So if I go here, this is for the typical floors, and you see we have beams at the middle and we have joists. For the beams, the ones on the middle, they are 315 by 722. The ones on the edge, the bay and they're 175 by 722. You see the width is almost half because it's carrying almost only the half weight of the span here. Okay, so let's go with the middle beams first. They are 315 by 722. Okay, so I'm gonna go here. I'm gonna go to L2. And I wanna go to the beam under the structure tab, beam, load family. And the folder we should be looking into is the structural framing. Wood. Maybe this one. Okay, I need to go to edit type, duplicate it. It's 315, the one in the middle, by 722. So I'm gonna go with 315 by 722. 315 in here, 722 in here. Okay, and I want to draw one from here to here. And the reason you don't see the beam is actually the view range. I'm gonna go to view range or VR, and I'm gonna change the bottom to see the level below, which is L1. Okay, so this is a beam. Now we can change this to fine to see the actual beam. I want to draw a section to see how it's gonna work in section. Okay, so I'm going to view section here. Maybe I would actually move this over there and move this here so it will show me the columns as well. I want to go to the section view. So this is the beam here. And again, I need to change the level of details to fine to be able to see the column. You can also change the TL to change the thick lines to thin lines in the view. Also, I want to add some dimensions in here in the section. Okay. So let me go to a different view in here, to a wall section. Okay, so the beam that I'm looking at right now is this beam here, right? So it's here. As you see, this is a beam, that's a joist. The height here is 10 feet. Okay, so I want to move the beam down so I have 10 feet or 38 millimeters clear span. Okay, I'm gonna check this dimension in here. Okay, and then I want to select this. So this is 35, 45. How about I select this? And I want to say the offset is negative 35, 45, and we have 30, 38 here. So 35, 45 minus 30, 38, 507. So I want to move this beam by negative 507 millimeters on both sides. Okay, so now the clear span is 30-38, which is the same as we have here in the wall section. It's all good. Now that it's good, I can go back here. This is the beam. I can copy the beam. And actually, I want to hit copy, and then I want to check the box for constraint and multiple, because it's more than one and it's only going in one direction. And I want to copy that all the way here, but not on the corners. For the corners, as you remember, we have a different beam for the bay end. It's 175 by 722. Okay, so I'm gonna copy one of these in here, and then I want to select this beam duplicate it, and I'm gonna go with 175 by 722. So this is gonna be 175. This is gonna be 175. Okay, and now I can copy this one all the way over there. Okay, so it looks like this. Okay, and if I go back here, you can see it says this plan is showing the typical floor framing above. So it's going to be the same on this level and the level above, but the roof has a different set of beams. So I want to select this and copy, paste them to, this is on level 2 to level 3. Okay, right. Now I need to go back to the section and make sure that on second view, second floor, we also have the correct clearance here. Okay, so you see on the second level, this number is not 3038, but it's 2695. So I'll go back here, and you don't see a column here. I'm gonna actually go back to one of the views, select the section, and move this further so you can see that column over there. Okay, now I want to go to annotate, get the dimension from here to here, and as you see, this is 2733. We want it to be 2695. So 2733 minus 2695 is 38. If I go here and select this beam, this should not be 507, but it should be 507 plus 38, which is 545. So if I change this beam, if I change the offset to negative 545 here and negative 545 in here, this is now 2695, which is the number we have here. So I want to select all the beams on this level. I can do it like this. You see 8 beams are selected, and I want to change all of them to negative 545 and negative 545. Okay. So that's for the two floors. For the third floor, the beams are actually different, so I'm gonna go to the roof in here. I'm gonna change this to fine so I can see the columns. If you don't still see the columns, go to view range and make sure to set the bottom to the level below. There we go. Now what I want to do is that I want to follow this one, which says plan showing roof framing, and if I go here, you see the columns are the same, but the beams have a different size. It's 315 by 646. So I'm gonna go back here. This is level roof, structure, beam, and I want to go to edit type, duplicate this, and this beam should be 315 by 646. So I'm gonna go with 646 here and here. Okay, very good. Now I can draw one of them here. Okay, and I can go to the section. That's the beam that I just created. Now we can take care of the height. This is now 3316. If I go to the wall section, that should be 2809. So 2809 minus 3316. 507 is the offset that we are looking for. So this should be negative. Negative 507. Negative 507. And that is now 2809. 2809. Okay. I can go back to the roof level. I can select this and copy multiple constraint. Okay. Also on the corner columns here, we have on the bay beams we have 175 by 646 again. So I want to go to the structure beam. I'm gonna go to edit type, duplicate it, and this should be 175. So 175. And 175 in here. Okay. And I want to draw it from here to here. If I go to the section, I also need to move that by negative 507, just like the other one, negative 507 on the two sides of the beam. And I can go to the roof, select that beam, copy to the very last one over there. Okay, so we set the beams correctly. In the next video, I'm going to show you how we can set the joists.